Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. So now that we have refactored our code, what is the next point? I mean, from here, where we can go? Well, there are quite a lot of things. We can actually achieve better refactoring if we had unit test cases already written for our application. But to be able to write the unit test cases, you will have to write the code that is in a state where you can write the test cases. Without that, it would not be possible. So since we have now taken that particular journey where we have refactored our code as per the solid compliance, now our application has resolved the complex dependencies. It is much more easy to write the test cases for this because you are introducing interfaces and dependency inversion principles. And because our code is much more stable because of this, your ability to automate the continuous integration and deployment, that is CI/CD, is much better. And that also means the release management also becomes much more easy to do. So from here, we can basically go in four different ways or four different branches. We can start learning about how to write the unit test cases, how to mock the objects, how to ensure that the code coverage of our code is better, and how to get a code coverage report of our application. You can then also start working towards learning how to introduce dependency inversion frameworks like Hilt or Dagger. So one of the precursors to use these kind of frameworks is your code is in a state to use these things. And by making it solid compliant, what we have done is we have ensured that we can now introduce these frameworks and tools to do these things. And then we can start writing CI/CD pipelines, because in the CI/CD pipeline, one of the major things that you are looking for is always checking what is your code coverage report. I mean, you can write a CI/CD without the code coverage report as well, but then what's the point of having such a CI/CD? And then finally, you can modularize your code. You can write multiple modules with completely isolated deployments. So your release management is something that you can start thinking about. So in the upcoming future videos, we will start exploring these things in a much more detailed manner. So stay tuned for those topics. Thanks for
brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.